Hi, and welcome to this tutorial for Electronica. In this video, I'm going to be demonstrating how you can capture the output of Electronica using Open Broadcaster. Open Broadcaster is a free open source screen capture tool and should work with all hardware setups. The standard Windows version supports using the central processing unit to encode video, and both Intel QuickSync and NVIDIA technologies for accelerating encoding on the graphics card or GPU. There is also a special version which supports accelerated encoding on AMD graphics cards. Additionally, there is a cross-platform version, but as far as I know, this version has fewer options and performs less well, so I don't recommend using this as Electronica only runs on Windows anyway. I've put download links to both the standard and AMD versions in the description of this video. In this video, I'll be demonstrating how to use the CPU encoder and the NVIDIA GPU encoder, but the same general principles and procedures will apply for Intel QuickSync and AMD GPUs. If you're not sure which make of GPU you have, you can use the GPUZ utility to find out. I put a link to its download page in the description as well. Download and install the appropriate version of Open Broadcaster and launch it. Next, launch Electronica and create or load your project. The first thing we need to do is to configure Open Broadcaster. Open Broadcaster is able to capture either the entire desktop, which is useful for capturing full screen output from Electronica, or just the Electronica output window, which can be used to capture both full screen and windowed output from Electronica. In order to capture the entire desktop, right-click on the Sources text box, and from the Add menu, select Monitor Capture. You can give the source a custom name, I'm just going to leave it as default. In the next window, the Monitor drop-down box allows you to select which monitor to capture from. I recommend unticking the Capture Mouse Cursor option to ensure that the mouse doesn't accidentally show up during recording. Once you've selected which monitor you want to capture, press OK at the bottom right. It's a good idea at this point to check that your capture is set up correctly by pressing on the Preview Stream button here at the bottom right. You should now see a preview of your capture. Note that the capture that I just demonstrated is coming from my second screen. In Electronica, I've added a second VOUT, and this is currently displaying on my other screen. If you're outputting Electronica to a window rather than full screen, you'll need to use either the window capture or game capture sources. For window capture, the first drop-down box allows you to select which window to capture. For Electronica, we want to select this one here called Display. Note that you need to have the display window open in Electronica before it will be available in this drop-down box. Again, you probably want to untick Capture Mouse Cursor. For the game capture source, the drop-down box again allows us to select which window to capture. In our case, we need to capture the Electronica display window. As with the previous sources, I recommend unticking Capture Mouse Cursor. Open Broadcaster is able to stream your capture to a web streaming service such as Twitch or YouTube. If, for example, you wanted to broadcast in 1080p, but only render the output of Electronica in 720p, you could use the Stretch Image to Screen option to achieve this. You could also do this for recordings, but it's probably better to resize the recording afterwards using software such as Virtual Dub or Adobe After Effects if you know how to. In my experience, both the window capture and game capture sources can be a little bit buggy, and may, for example, fail to capture if you close Electronica's output window and then reopen it. If you only see a black screen when you press the Preview Stream button, try restarting Open Broadcaster and or Electronica. Also, make sure that the checkbox for desired source here is checked. So far, all the options we've configured are for Open Broadcaster's input. Now, let's configure its output by pressing on the Settings button here. There are quite a few settings, so I'm just going to cover the important ones. Firstly, under Encoding, the Encoder option allows you to select which encoder will be used to compress the output. X264 will be available on all systems. The availability of the other encoders will depend on your system hardware. For example, my CPU doesn't support Intel QuickSync, so I can't select this. And AMD version of Open Broadcaster won't have the NVIDIA NVENC option. The X264 encoder, which I'll demonstrate first, can use a lot of CPU and reduce your FPS in Electronica. So in my experience, if you can, it's better to use one of the GPU encoders if you have a recent enough graphics card. For recordings, you probably want to increase this max bitrate value from 1000 to 4000 or 6000. But be aware that this value affects file size and, more importantly, CPU usage. So you should test different values to determine what works best on your system. You can monitor your CPU usage by opening the Windows Task Manager, either by simultaneously pressing the Control, Shift, and Escape keys on your keyboard, or pressing Control, Alt, and Delete at the same time and selecting Task Manager. Click on More Details, and then switch to the Performance tab, where you can see a graph displaying CPU usage. You can also see CPU usage per application by clicking on the Details tab and sorting by CPU. If you have more than one graphics card, in Open Broadcaster's video settings, you should choose which one to use here for video capture. The base resolution setting determines the size of the recorded output. Generally, this should be the same size as the output of Electronica, but as I mentioned, you could use the Game Capture Sources Stretch Image to Screen option to upscale a lower resolution input to a higher resolution output. If you're using the monitor capture source, and your second monitor has a different resolution to your main one, make sure the setting is correct. You can select the monitor option instead of the custom one to be sure. Conversely, if you wanted to render the output of Electronica at a higher resolution and record or stream the output of Open Broadcaster at a lower one, for example, if your internet connection's upload speed isn't fast enough to stream in full HD, you can use the resolution downscale option to do this. The filter option then determines the quality of the scaling. Better quality will use more system resources. The FPS option determines the frame rate of Open Broadcaster's output and should be the same as your frame rate in Electronica, although a lower frame rate in Open Broadcaster will mean a reduced file or stream size. So again, you could output Electronica at 60 frames per second and capture or stream it at just 30 frames per second. Under Advanced Options, this video pane will change depending on which encoder you selected in the video options up here. For x264, changing this preset option will determine how much CPU is used for performing the encoding. Faster settings may result in larger file sizes and or more CPU usage when playing back, but you should check the results for yourself to see what works best. For NVIDIA's NVENC, you may want to use even higher bit rates under the video options, as the encoding is performed on the graphics card rather than the CPU, the impact on Electronica's frame rate is negligible, so the impact of the setting will be greater on file size and output quality than it will be on performance. Again, back in the advanced options section, the only important option to mention here is preset. Automatic should be fine, but you may be able to get better results by choosing a different preset. I assume if you use the Quick Sync encoder, you'd find a similar set of options here, and there are yet more options under the QuickSync encoder page. If you're interested in streaming your output online, you can do this pretty easily in Open Broadcaster. The settings for this are under the broadcast settings. There are too many to cover here, but it does come with some pretty helpful presets. Note you can both stream and record at the same time. By default, Open Broadcaster captures the sound coming from your microphone. You probably want to disable this under audio settings by changing microphone setting to disable. You can also select which device to capture sound from under the desktop audio device settings. Default should be fine, but if you find you're not capturing sound, you probably need to change this from default to speakers. Failing that, you can try and change the microphone setting to stereo mix if it's available. Now that we've configured all the necessary settings in Open Broadcaster, we can record Electronica's output. In order to record, click on the Start Recording button here, and likewise to start streaming, just press the Start Streaming button above it. Once you're done, press Stop Recording and or Stop Streaming. You can view the recordings you've made by going to File, Open Recordings folder. Neither Open Broadcaster saves videos in the FLV or Flash Video Container, so you most likely need the Flash Video codec installed to view them. You can convert them to a different container, such as AVI, MP4, or MOV, using software such as VirtualDub, AVI DMux, Windows Movie Maker, or either of Adobe After Effects or Premiere. There are already a lot of tutorials on how to do this elsewhere on YouTube, so I'm not going to cover that in this video. In addition to Open Broadcaster, there are a variety of other options, including NVIDIA ShadowPlay, Fraps, CamStudio, DX3, Bandicam, D3D Gear, and Action, which may have additional features. However, other than ShadowPlay, which is included with all recent NVIDIA graphics cards, none of these are free, and their performance is the same or less good than that of Open Broadcaster. Some of these may give better results on systems with AMD graphics cards, but at this time I'm not able to test that. So if you do have an AMD card, it might be worth exploring these options further. D3D Gear in particular specifically mentions the ability to use AMD graphics cards to accelerate capturing, though some of the others I mentioned may also be able to do this. Note that I haven't extensively tested any of these other options, so you should make use of their free trials to ensure compatibility before making any purchases. Okay, that's all for this video. If you found it helpful, please give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel for updates about new electronica tutorials. And as usual, if you have any questions, post them in the comments or in the Facebook group. Thanks for watching.